And prove Jesus, but now Jesus was in trouble in their mind. But when Jesus prayed for Lazarus, he said, "My Father, I want you to move and let them see your power working from heaven." And even today, the Jewish people don't believe that Jesus was God wrapped up in a body of flesh. So he said, "Look at here. You can't take my life. I'm going to lay it down and I'm going to pick it up." What did they say about it? The beginning of the show for him said he was going to get up 3 days later. So let me tell you, Jesus had to get out of that grave. If he had not got out of that grave, if they had went to that tomb, and that tomb would have been full, they could have found Jesus' body. Jesus' ministry would have stopped in his tracks. But when they went and looked in, all three of them got different renditions. When they looked in, they didn't see nobody. And the angel said, "Who you're looking for? You're looking for Jesus. I know who you're looking for. But I want you to understand, he ain't him. He got up just a little while ago. Just before you got here, he got up. They found something, some evidence. Good God Almighty, evidence that they found was a wrap that Jesus was wrapped up in. It was still there. The head wrap that he wrapped Jesus up in, it was still there. But the fact is, and the report is, you know, good God Almighty, he got up from there and everything's arranged.
I'm gonna face to face. I'm gonna talk to Jesus.
hallelujah, had it right. And then praise God is that their prayer is your strength. Hallelujah. And then he says here, praise God, grave, where is your victory? Let me tell you, praise God, the grave can hell them down all through the centuries. Nobody can get out of the grave but Lazarus and one more, praise God. You see, the others he healed, they ain't going to the grave. But the only somebody that had gotten out of the grave was Lazarus. And you go back in time when Elijah, praise God, was being buried. His body dropped over on some bones in the grave. And the bone got up out of the grave. Ain't God all right? Good God Almighty, so brave. Where's the victory? Well, the grave don't have no victory. How you know preaching? How you know preaching? Well, on the third day, when Jesus came out of the grave, they tell me that they looked around in Jerusalem and saw the soul of some of those who had died before Jesus died. Tell me that they saw some of them walking the streets of Jerusalem. That's why I can tell you that I believe the record. Ain't God all right? Yeah. He said now, the stain of death is sin. Praise God, the tomb is empty. And praise God, sin is defeated. Hallelujah. When Jesus went in the grave and came out of the grave, sin met a match. Sin got a knockout punch. Because Jesus came out of the grave, ain't God all right? Praise God. And guess what? Praise God, he went, got out of the grave. He's not going back in.
I believe that the tomb was empty. Yeah. And it's important, praise God, to understand, praise God, the significance of the empty tomb. Praise the Lord. The tomb is empty. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, come right now, thanking you for what you did on the cross. I thank the Lord because you didn't do it grudgingly. You did it with joy. I thank you, God, Heavenly Father, for you said in your word that it pleased you to put Jesus on the cross. Thank you, Lord, for being so merciful for me. Right now, Lord, in the name of Jesus, I'm asking you to move on the hearts and minds of everybody in this place. Perhaps there's somebody in here who have really not comprehended the importance of the empty tomb. First of all, the death of the cross and the burial of the empty tomb. We're asking you right now, in the name of Jesus, move on the hearts, move on the mind. Let them know, Lord, that the key to eternal life is they accept you and acknowledge you as Lord and Savior. Thank you, Jesus. No matter what the world say, you've got the victory. And when you came out of that tomb, you had the keys of death and hell in your hands, and nobody can turn the key on death or hell unless it come back. God, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. Let them know that it's dangerous every day they live without knowing you as Lord and Savior. Move, Lord. Convict right now. Bring the confession to the outside, Lord. The word says the word is not even in that knowledge in our heart. The word of faith is flourishing. I want the church to know right now. There's nothing we can preach it to you. It's already in you. Go by the Holy Spirit. Go in by the word and wine. Praise God and begin to grow. And by faith. The Bible simply says in Romans 10:9-10, said, if thou wilt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. This here will be, might be, but it said shall be saved. For with the heart a man believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. There were one here today. God has spoken to you. And you know if God require your soul of you right now, you wouldn't be ready to go back with God. Now is your time. Yes. Now is your time. Yeah. Praise God. Very simple. Bible has taught me 8th chapter book of Acts when Philip preached to the eunuch. Philip being an apostolic brother. He told him about the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, and also told him about baptism. They were going along. He said, see, here's water. What hindered me? Thank God he was trying to build Philip's Baptist Church. Philip simply asked him a question. See, you won't want a guy. I need to ask you a question. Do you believe? The eunuch simply said, I believe that Jesus Christ was the Son of the God. When he said that, made that confession, guess what? God, Philip went down and baptized him. And after Philip got to baptize him, God called Philip away from him. Didn't let him, praise God, get his first meal of his church. He became a body of Christ. Will there be one? Became part of the body of Christ. Will there be one? You're not too young. You're not too old. Let me put it this way. You're not too young to be saved. You're not too young or old to be saved. But I assure you, praise God, if you come into the knowledge of the Word of God, God, I'm not going to punish anybody who don't have the knowledge. But if you come into the knowledge of the Word of God and reject it, you're not too young or you're not too old to go to hell. It's just that simple. People don't talk about hell anymore. But it's either heaven or hell. God bless you. Whatever you want. Those in the church is open for membership. Praise God, there's someone here who didn't come and just came, and God has spoken to you. He told you that this is the place where you should come and put your membership under the watch here of this ministry. If you will rise and come, praise God, we'll give you right here in fellowship right now. Or, praise God, we have our information card. You can fill out quickly. Praise God. God bless you. God bless you.